Hi everyone. So in Excel, worksheets can sometimes contain cumbersome lists of data and you need a quick way to find specific information within these lists. This is where Excel's VLOOKUP function comes in handy. And I'm going to show you not only how to use the function, but how to set up a proper table so that you can use it easily. If you were wondering, the V in VLOOKUP stands for vertical. This formula is used when the comparison value is in a column of the table. Before getting started, do you notice a difference between these two tables? Take a closer look. The table on the left is not a lookup table because it contains a manual range of values, meaning you put in the range with this hyphen mark. The table on the right is a lookup table. This is because for a lookup table to work in Excel, column 1 of the lookup table must contain only the lowest number in each range. Let's try it. Let's say we are a teacher trying to input the letter grade of our students based on their marks. Imagine having 300 students and having to do this. It would take forever to manually type this in, but only a few seconds with the VLOOKUP function and a table array. This is why I love using this function. It saves so much time. So first we'll type in equal VLOOKUP. Then for our purposes, I'll open our insert function dialog box so we can see the different parts that are needed to complete this function. First, we have the lookup value, which is, in our case, is Watson's 63%. Could have tried harder, Watson. I'm joking, but this is our value that we want to compare in our table or the value we already know about. The table array is this table. Notice again that only the lowest number in a range is needed. So you have to highlight this table or type in the range. And it's probably good practice to press the F4 key, which will grab hold of this table range so that we copy this function down, that range doesn't move down as well. And it will if you don't press F4 after highlighting it. Lastly, we have to type in the column number or the column with the information that we need. This table has only two columns starting from left to right. This is column 1 and this is column 2. We need the information from column 2, so we type in 2 into the column index number space. Now we have our value, and because we pressed F4 on our table array, we can then copy this down to retrieve the letter grade of our other students. Let's repeat this again to complete our tax rate worksheet. First, I will calculate Jane Doe's tax rate and then copy down like we did in our last sheet. First, I'll type in equal VLOOKUP. Press my insert function dialog box, then use the value in cell B10 as our lookup value. Then I'll highlight the table and remember to press F4 after to keep it in place. Lastly, I'll type in 2 as this information is the information we need and it's in the second column. Let's try a different kind of VLOOKUP table. Notice this table in our health plan worksheet is a little different. It's not a range that we want to look up, but an exact number or value. There is an option in our VLOOKUP that allows us to do this. Let me show you. So we'll complete our VLOOKUP like we did in our previous worksheets, but then when we get to the range lookup section, we have to type false to let the VLOOKUP function know we are not looking up a range of numbers, but an exact match. The default is a range, which is why we didn't have to fill this part out before. By typing false, we are telling the VLOOKUP function that this is not a regular lookup table. Then we can press OK and get our exact match value. This last worksheet I will cover in my next video, and it will compare the VLOOKUP function to the IF function. If you are looking for more information on the VLOOKUP function, I have this video here that describes many functions in Excel, including the VLOOKUP function and more, so check that out.